the patterns in your data change with time. In that case, your best bet is to use a recurrent neural network. This deep learning model has a simple structure with a built-in feedback loop, allowing it to act as a forecasting engine. Let's take a closer look. Recurrent neural networks, or RNNs, have a long history, but their recent popularity is mostly due to the works of Juergen Schmidhuber, Sepp Hochreiter, and Alex Graves. Their applications are extremely versatile, ranging from speech recognition to driverless cars. All the nets we've seen up to this point have been feed-forward neural networks. In a feed-forward neural network, signals flow in only one direction from input to output, one layer at a time. In a recurrent net, the output of a layer is added to the next input and fed back into the same layer, which is typically the only layer in the entire network. You can think of this process as a passage through time. Shown here are four such time steps. At t equals 1, the net takes the output of time t equals 0 and sends it back into the net along with the next input. The net repeats this for t equals 2, t equals 3, and so on. Unlike feedforward nets, a recurrent net can receive a sequence of values as input, and it can also produce a sequence of values as output. The ability to operate with sequences opens up these nets to a wide variety of applications. Here are a few examples. When the input is singular and the output is a sequence, a potential application is image captioning. A sequence of inputs with a single output can be used for document classification. When both the input and output are sequences, these nets can classify videos frame by frame. If a time delay is introduced, the net can statistically forecast the demand in supply chain planning. Have you ever used an RNN for one of these applications? If so, please comment and share your experiences. Like we've seen with previous deep learning models, by stacking RNNs on top of each other, you can form a net capable of more complex output than a single RNN working alone. Typically, an RNN is an extremely difficult net to train. Since these nets use backpropagation, we once again run into the problem of the vanishing gradient. Unfortunately, the vanishing gradient is exponentially worse for an RNN. The reason for this is that each time step is the equivalent of an entire layer in a feed-forward network. So training an RNN for 100 time steps is like training a 100-layer feed-forward net. This leads to exponentially small gradients and a decay of information through time. There are several ways to address this problem, the most popular of which is gating. Gating is a technique that helps the net decide when to forget the current input and when to remember it for future time steps. The most popular gating types today are GRU and LSTM. Besides gating, there are also a few other techniques like gradient clipping, steeper gates, and better optimizers. When it comes to training a recurrent net, GPUs are an obvious choice over an ordinary CPU. This was validated by a research team at Indico, which uses these nets on text processing tasks like sentiment analysis and helpfulness extraction. The team found that GPUs were able to train the nets 250 times faster. That's the difference between one day of training and over 8 months. So, under what circumstances would you use a recurrent net over a feed-forward net? We know that a feed-forward net outputs one value, which in many cases was a class or a prediction. A recurrent net is suited for time series data, where an output can be the next value in a sequence, or the next several values. So the answer depends on whether the application calls for classification, regression, or forecasting. In the next video, we'll take a look at a family of deep learning models known as the autoencoders.